by virtue of the powers vested in me by the Constitution and by law, I had to declare martial law.
What they've done is they've gone in and put these huge gas furnaces on all of these warehouse buildings and poured concrete floors in those buildings.
The FEMA camp bill allows the government to run at least 6 military installations when a national emergency is declared. These emergency centers would be run by FEMA under the command of the Secretary of Homeland Security.
They've also put up 3 different sets of electronically operable capital boxes on them that are motion activated.
Reduce the population of the planet down to 500 million, have one world currency under the Homeland Security, or FEMA if you want to call it, they're going to declare an emergency.
Some of the people that were going to the FEMA fusion centers were not to be heard or seen from again. I know that a lot of people know that I was there involved in some of the search and rescue and some other things that were going on.
So I'm standing here in front of Southwest Key Programs, Casa Padre, and this is a former Walmart that has been turned into a center for children. So behind those doors inside that Walmart are apparently many hundreds of children.
Donald Trump declares a national emergency and martial law against the elite, the cabal.
A few years ago, a similar bill was presented in Congress, but it didn't go anywhere over concerns that the broad language can lead to sweeping, unchecked government power. Now there's this new version of the bill. What's changed?
Well, they took out the vague language so that the centers are specifically set up to house, shelter, even educate people for extended periods of time, but they are limited to that specific purpose.
Numbers are too close together to be a parking area. We've gone over there countless times. Nobody parks in that area. And there are 4 helicopter windows hanging up there, and over on the electrical wires across the street that run alongside it, there's helicopter orange balls. We put smart wires alongside of it.
Senator Merkley is irresponsibly spreading blatant lies about routine immigration enforcement. Let's stop right there. Is it routine to have hundreds of children?
They have a new policy they've implemented. They started a pilot project last summer. Now they've implemented it completely, of taking away children from parents when they families are seeking asylum, even when they present themselves legally at border posts.
They were loading up with as many people, it's got to be dozens of people in the back.
Oh my gosh.
They take them to a nearby Walmart, and then the Walmart is where I guess metro buses or school buses will take them to the shelter. The question is, what shelter are they taking them to? Because I heard Tom say GRB is overcrowded. And
this legislation is meant to be enacted in the event of an emergency. But what exactly does that mean? What is the definition of emergency, especially when it comes to this legislation? When would it be enacted?
I published a book called Chaos in America.
Mm-hmm.
In it, I was asked to build an enemy prisoner of war camp. I put the contract in this book, so you can read it for yourself. This is in downtown Las Vegas, right on the railroad tracks. It says enemy prisoner of war camp. They're all on top. They're building them all the way across the United States right now.
To go back to 1988 to the Stafford Act bill to actually get the definition of emergency, and this covers things like tornadoes, floods, hurricanes, natural disasters, but it also gives the president to declare an emergency to avert a catastrophe, which raises the issue of preemptiveness.
And I need to tell this story because some of these things are still going on. It's very important because this covers what people have considered to be conspiracy theory. It is what people have not been told in the media. And it's the kind of thing that the government and the media covers up so that people don't have an understanding of what's going on.
It's unaccompanied children under those administrations. These are children who are accompanied by their parents, being taken away from their parents when they're seeking asylum. That is new, that is different, that has not been done before.
FEMA, Walmart, Texas, but locations are closed everywhere, so how many other children do they have enslaved? Like I said, they're saying children that are of immigrant nature and of not being accompanied.
It's a slippery slope. Once the government has its power and all these centers are set up, and it's at least six, maybe more, probably more, there is a real potential for the abuse of power here.
They say there are six disaster distribution centers strategically located across the country and stocked to provide rapid response to communities in the event of a natural disaster. Each distribution center is more than 1 million square feet in size, and they distribute to 90 to 100 stores each.
We talked to one fellow that worked on some of the repairs, and he said that while they were doing this work, they also cleaned out an underground tunnel, which we thought was kind of odd.
Absolutely. I think the people I talked to, all, with the exception of one, they all were eager to go wherever the truck would take.
There is going to be more terrorism, and that's what Bush wants. The internationalists got to have terrorism, because the only way you get the American people to beg for martial law is to give up their rights. So we know more terrorism is coming. I'm a retired police officer. We talked to police and soldiers a long time, and they all know this. There will be more terrorism. And of course, then we give up our rights, and we're going to be under martial law.
Possible child trafficking, sex trafficking, all that stuff could be happening, especially in such an enclosed environment. So secretive. Dark windows, as you've seen on the video that I had showed you just a few seconds ago.
We have this map that shows how the U.S. would be divided in the event of an emergency, if we can pull that out there. There it is. So this is how the U.S. will be divided into districts. You see 10 of them there.
Bush signed an executive order taking the old forts and the army places that we shut down to get those organized to hold the so-called dissidents. Now, what's the definition of a dissident? And the problem is that we're going to enslave ourselves, because most of the people want to keep having food coming in, and you're going to follow the line. You're just locking yourself into your own prison camp. Then we're going to come down to the extermination.
The things that they have in common seem to be, you know, the extraordinary amount of fencing, plus it's near a railroad track, you know, plus obviously there's room to hold a lot of people.
It's all orchestrated, and it's going to be more terrorism, because the way, the easiest way to get the American people to not just beg for martial law, but demand it of their officials. When they're scared enough, they'll give up everything to be made safe.
So these new emergency centers will be spread out throughout the United States, in most of these eventually, and it gives FEMA and the Department of Homeland Security jurisdiction over what goes on in these places during a time of emergency.
Some of the top cops, or maybe some of them know, and some of them don't. But the ones that even do won't do anything about it, because most of them are part of the agenda as well.
All I could hear that night was car alarms going off and glass breaking and gunshots.